And there are such things as government guidelines, etc., etc. But it would be good for us to start with. What really is this thing all about that we have to prepare for? That we have to prepare for in the context of safety, diba? So, first off, alam ko naman, alam nyo na to. I know that you know this. For example, COVID-19 started as an epidemic. I remember vividly, I was in China in November. There was already speculation, but nobody was really into it kasi they're just mere speculations. But after December, January came, and then there was already a lockdown in the whole province of Wuhan. So at that time, epidemic pa lang siya kasi it's concentrated on a certain place, diba? But lo and behold, it traveled so fast to different places. And then hanggang March 14, napilitan ng ating gobyerno na mag-declare ng pandemic. So the government has been forced to declare a lockdown. So lahat tayo apektado na, business, academics, lahat. Nobody's spared. And of course, it's not only in the Philippines. Buong mundo yan. Kaya yung impact, hindi lang regional or a certain part of the global world, but almost everywhere. Pag tinignan nyo nga yung report about COVID in the website of WHO, tapos madami pang mga website na nag-feature niyan, talaga makikita mo all countries are affected. Siguro yung hindi affected yung mga isa o dalawa lang o mga isolated cases. But technically, if you take a look at it, talagang worldwide yung spread niya. So it now becomes a pandemic. Now, ano yung likelihood na it was similar to the Spanish flu in the early 1900s, di ba? Ano yung likelihood? Well, of course, during that time, madami ding affected whole wide world then. But, no, ngayon lang ba meron coronavirus or the so-called COVID? Sa totoo lang, it started in the early 2000. So, parang pagka-millennium, meron agad tayong experience na something different. Of course, it's viral in nature. So around 2002, nagkaroon ng SARS-1. Again, tong SARS-1 is, of course, under siya sa family or it belongs to the coronavirus family. Eh, anong nangyari nung SARS-1? So parang regional siya. Parang even if na, may mga transmitted to Canada and other parts of the world, hindi ganun kadami. So, contained right away. In short, parang isolated pa rin. But the question is, after that, had there been any development on vaccine? So, you can scroll, you can go to Google and check out if there was really some sort of seriousness given to address the issue. It looks like parang there were groups then who were studying about development of vaccine, pero none of those that address COVID-19, that address coronavirus really came into fruition. For some reason, we don't know. Maybe governments or nations have other priorities. But is it something new? Yun yung question. Hindi naman, kasi dati na nga, 2000. But you know, virus has a power to mutate, di ba? It has the ability to mutate. So we don't know how it happens, but we can only study how come it was able to mutate. So yun yung nangyari na until this time, they are still on the theory that it was transmitted from an animal to the human being. Pero it remained to be found out. Hindi pa yan sure. Or hindi naman talaga yan from animal to human. Baka naman from human to human yan. But since it's viral in nature, wala pang makapagsasabi. Now, after COVID-19, nung pagka-submit ng China ng genome property ng virus, yung COV-2, to the whole world, kasi they shared information about what this virus is all about. So nagkaroon ba ng mga development? Meron. Kaya nga, ano yung mga many issues? One of the many issues would be the race in producing vaccine. Race, ibig sabihin mauna, magaling. Alright. So, kaya if you notice the president's, every 2 weeks, the president's trying to tell us that there's already this, there's already that, we've come up with Bayanihan 2, etc. So, ang daming mga issues, even issues on corruption, issues on politics, gaya sa Amerika, very strong and powerful talaga yung play of politics sa kanila na to the point na nadadama yung mga pasyente. That's why, if you take a look at it, there was really a chaotic response from people. And tingnan nyo naman yung Australia, di ba? Yung Melbourne, lockdown talaga sila. So, in fact, they even reported and shared that they lost billions of dollars. So, sino bang hindi nawalan? So, that's the point. Those are just issues brought about by COVID. Now, is it really a phenomenon? I believe so. Kasi hindi, it's just like natural calamity, like when volcanic, like there's a volcanic eruption. As of the moment, medyo kinakabahan din yung mga residents are along three active volcanoes, di ba, na baka magkaroon ng eruption, etc. So, how is it similar? How does this particular virus similar with that? Eh, parehas yan beyond our control, eh. Alright? Kasi, it can spread by, until now, hindi nga natin alam who's yung pinaka zero patient na nag-spread nun, right? So, we won't be able, pero what we can only do is, also one of the many issues is to come out with a vaccine and at the same time, cure. There are a lot of news coming out that there are already vaccines coming this September. So, even the president himself was excited to report that in his last last address to us. This one from Russia. Eh, ang Russia naman is well known for development of different vaccines since time immemorial. So, trust-wise, if we are talking about who to believe to or who to trust to when it comes to vaccine development, parang may track record naman yung Russia. And so many other issues that can be dismissed at the end of the day as phenomenal. Yung pagkakaroon ng COVID-19. So, ang tanong, are we safe? How do we know we are safe? Diba? So, my role today is to give you an overview kung talagang the whole world, if the whole world is really into safety. Okay, allow me to share this quote first before we proceed, no? Si Chaim Potok, sabi niya, everything has passed, okay? Everything, a person, object, etc. If you don't know the past, you can't understand the present. So, I like us to dwell in this perspective. So, we have to know the past. So, itong nangyayari sa atin ngayon, this is going to be past in the near, maybe tomorrow. So, while waiting for the vaccine, we are already making our past. In short, itong quote na to, I included it in my short talk we do, in my short sharing, because I believe that we all have to know what we're going through. Hindi to responsibility lang ng isang tao, isang guro, or isang bata, or isang matanda. But it is everyone's responsibility for us to really know what's happening. So, hindi yung know na galing sa isang tao, hindi yung know na tinuro ng isang guro. This is something that we as people have to know so we can understand tomorrow or the present for other people. And so that we can prepare or plan properly. Kasi pag walang understanding ng past, what happens in the present is bahala na. And when we have that kind of attitude in the present, like come what may, what will you plan for? Nothing, right? So that's why I included it with the perspective na sa kamay ng gobyerno ay mabuti kung spared. Eh kahit na mayaman, kahit na mahirap, kung COVID man yan, kung walang na-spare dyan, nobody is spared, okay? So, after yung mga quote na yon, ang gusto kong, from those quotes that's afternoon is, literature that is around us that you can access anywhere from the net. For what reason, mamaya, towards the conclusion, I'll tell. Kasi, most of, ewan ko kung may kilala kayo, they rely only on someone else's understanding of the situation, someone else's thoughts or insight of the situation. But as a teacher, as an educator, it is my challenge for all of us today that it would be better if we have personal and desire to know more about what's going on. What I mean with personal desire is you do your own research.